I'm here today to introduce you to a new tool of a text software. The new tool can be found to the text software page, textsoft.it, and under a Gantt chart. It is an Excel macro that will plot a Gantt chart from a few parameters of activity. The software can be downloaded clicking on the zip file, and an instruction can be found on the PDF. When you open and you download the file on your machine, you have a zip file containing the Excel file and the PDF. PDF here is an instruction manual very briefly introducing all the key works elements of the tool and what has to be done and not to be done. Now let's go and open the Gantt chart Excel file. I just want to remind you that the Excel file is run by a VBA macro. Therefore, all the VBA code, VBA macro has to be enabled in Excel. If you prompt, you also have to enable the file. At the beginning, you'll be reminded who's the users and the expiry date of the software. You click OK and a menu will be popping up. We exit from the menu because we need to, first of all, to set up what we want to print. The activity with the attribute will be insert in the table tab. Now, here I have an export from a Primavera P6 with a lot of attributes for activity. Can be also something very simple. The minimum key attributes that have to be set for the tool to work can be found in order setup. The activity ID as a unique identifier for activity, the activity name that is a description of activity, the start and finish date, of course, and let finish if you do want to plot the float for the activity, what will be how much the activity can be delayed without impacting the project completion dates. If you don't want to have this information, we can put a let finish equal to the finish dates and the activity status. The activity status will tell us if activity started, non started, completed or in progress. For example, for activity start non started, we say that are green, so we put a code for. For a start, we can say it's light blue, so we can say it like in progress. And for a complete, we can say what is a dark blue, 3. When we end this description, of course, we need to match whatever we have here. So you see actual status on column 28, so we go to column 28. Column 28, and we find activity status. When we have done all this, we are ready to run our software because we map for each field of a report we produce from our software the attribute that has to be imported. This is let the freedom to import reports from Primavera, Asta Power Project, Tylos, Microsoft Project, Spider Project, also to create your own Gantt chart in Excel. However, let's go to see the Gantt. Here, for example, I can see have the results of the previous run. I will invoke the menu. I will clear the Gantt. I'll be prompted if I want to clear. I say yes, and all the menu will be open. At this point, I rerun the menu and I plot the Gantt. Depending from how many activities we have, we'll be waiting a few minutes. As you can see, the colors now is depending from the status of activity, not started, in progress, and completed. The milestone, we decide to put for a start milestone a dot M in blue, and for a finish milestone a dot M in red. And you see here, we have the float at the end. And this is really all the tool. What I want to show you is the advanced use of this tool. So as for example, you say, you don't want the float, so we can put let finish equal finish. So for all activity, we don't have a float. Of course, for a start milestone, we have to put equal to this one. At this point, I can go back to my Gantt chart. I rerun the clean chart. And I call the menu and I replot my chart. Replotting my chart, this time we will see that the float bar are not plotted. Now everything is fine, but you will ask me, I don't want the early days here because I don't have. Actually, I might want to put duration or whatsoever coming from if there's an Excel file prepared, which is a gang doing the work, and I want to put if activity is a critical or non-critical. So, easy. For example, if I want to put in my report the original completion remaining duration, I'm going to check and I see that these are starting column 14, 15, and 16. So instead of early start, I go follow 14, 15, and 16. This will not be automatically updated yet, will be in the next version. And then I want to put if it's a critical. Critical, we go, and we see what the critical is in column 34. So I'm going to put column 34 pointing. At this point, critical could be yes or no. So I need to update the type string. And then they say if it's a critical, I want to be red. And if it's not critical, any color I can choose. And I put one. I go on my Gantt chart. I recall the menu. I clear the chart. Do you want to erase? Yes. I rerun the menu and I run my chart. And it will be shortly prompt with the results. As you see, base if it's a critical is plotted in red. Now, how you can see here, the information is put as date. Nothing easier. I go and I can change the format as I want. This is really giving you freedom to customize whatever you can see. The important are activity ID, activity name, start, finish dates, late finish if you want to draw the float. A string if you want to color code the bar based on certain characteristics that can be defined by this field, and you have three fields where you can actually put the information you want. This is of the software. Then you have here a little reminder if you like the software and you want to keep running and using beyond the 3 year period, how you can contact the support team. I hope you enjoyed the video and find it of your useful for you.